हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी योर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर ग्रामर सेक्शन, एक्टिव एंड पैसिव वॉइस। नाउ एट फर्स्ट यू हैव टू नो अबाउट एक्टिव एंड पैसिव वॉइस। व्हाट इज एक्टिव एंड व्हाट इज पैसिव वॉइस? फॉर इट इज very easy to understand active and passive voice. Here you see, here is a sentence: he wrote a letter. And the same sentence is, you can see here, a letter was written by him. Student, you see, in most sentences, the subject of the sentence is the doer of an action, and the object of the sentence is the receiver of the action. Okay, means you see, the verb that expresses the action, is carried out by the subject is said to be in the active voice. The active voice is used when the agent of the doer is to be made prominent with active voice. And now when you talk about passive voice, it's fully different. In a passive voice, you have to change it in the form like that. Here in he is subject, roots is object, and a letter, roots is verb and a letter is object. When you change it into passive voice, at that time he will take place of object and a letter, object will take place of subject. Here you see a letter, here is as a subject a letter, and according to the sentence you have to change it in form like that. You see, he paints a wall. Okay, he paints a wall, he is subject, paints verb, a wall is object. He paints a wall is object. Here it will take place of subject, a wall, and it is a simple present tense. In simple present tense, you have to use is rm. So you will write here, you will use here helping verb is, the wall is, and you have to use the verb third. So paints, third form, painted, and before the object you have to use by him. A wall is painted by him. Okay, this is the example. Now for present continuous, you see that he is painting a wall. Painting is sujat, present continuous tense. You will write it here, a wall. A wall will take place here, and to adjust ing you will use being. Okay, being, and after that painted, third form, a wall is being painted by him. Means you see here, in the with the green pen, this bold letter is a helping verb here, and it has been used here as a changing. Now the next you see here, present perfect tense, he has painted a wall. He has painted a wall, it is a example of present perfect tense. And you change it into passive voice, a wall. And in present perfect tense, you have to use the helping verb of present perfect continuous. So in present perfect continuous, it is has been and have been is used. So you will use here, a wall has been painted by him. Okay, now simple past. For simple past, you see the same sentence is here. Here he painted a wall. You see here, this is the second form of the verb, he painted a wall. And when you change it in passive voice, you see a wall. And to simple past, you have to convert it into simple past continuous. And in past continuous, the helping verb is was and were. So a wall was, according to the sentence it is singular, so was, a wall was painted by him. Okay, now you see here, he was painting a wall. Now this is a example of past continuous tense. For past continuous tense, you see here, was and painting verb ing, at that time to adjust ing you will also use here being, and the helping verb will be same, a wall was being painted by him. A wall was being painted by him. Okay, now student, you see the another example from past perfect. Past perfect, in past perfect had its recognition had plus verb ka third form. He had painted a wall. So to convert it into passive voice, you have to use past perfect continuous helping verb. He had painted a wall, and you will use here had been. Had been is used in past perfect continuous tense. So a wall and had will convert into had been, and painted by he will convert into him. Okay, by him. Now you see simple future. He will paint a wall. He will paint all means in simple future. It is used will and shall. Will with the he, she, it, they, and I is used with I and we. Shall which shall is used with I and we. So here he will paint a wall. You see here a wall and will is a simple future, and in simple future will be converted into future continuous. In future continuous, will be and shall be is used. So you will convert it into will be and shall be. You will write here a wall will be painted by him. Okay, now you see future continuous tense. In future continuous, he will be and shall be is used as a auxiliary or helping verb. He will be painting a wall. But according to the rule of active and passive voice, in future continuous there is no change. So you see here there is blank place. It means in a future continuous there will be no changing. Okay, now future perfect tense. In a future perfect tense, you see here example, he will have painted a wall. In future perfect tense, the helping verb is will have and shall have. Here with the he will have has been used. He will have painted a wall. When you will convert it into passive voice, at that time a wall is take place of he, means a subject, and after that a have been means past perfect. Future perfect will take place of future perfect continuous helping verb. Will have been, a wall will have been painted by him. Okay student, this is the structure of active and passive voice to change it from active to passive. A simple structure form, and we have also another form. You can see it as I have written it in on the board. You see here he is reading, he is painting a portrait. Okay, you see here a portrait is being painted by him. A portrait is being painted by him. Okay, like that the second example is Ravi writes a letter to his father. You see here a letter is written by Ravi to his father. Okay, you see here this is example of present continuous tense, and here to adjust ing to here I have used you see here Ravi writes a letter to his father. A letter is written to Ravi by Ravi to his father. Next is the captain called the players. Called the players past simple past है. इसको देखिए कैसे change हुआ है. The players were called. The players were called by the captain. Okay. Now you see also the next example is she drank the glass of milk. You see here the glass of milk. Okay. Was and drink drank third form is drunk by her. See यहाँ पे her के रूप में convert हो गया है. The glass of milk was drunk by her. Okay, you see here students interrogative form of the active and passive voice. Who taught you English? The sentence belong to simple past because taught is the second form of teach. You see here who taught you English. In this condition we convert it to who to in by whom. Okay, you see here by whom. Okay, by whom, और past simple past है तो past continuous का हेल्पिंग वर्ब यहाँ पर यूज होगा, सो यू विल राइट हियर वाज एंड वर, इंग्लिश इज सिंगुलर, सो हियर वाज बाय हुम वाज इंग्लिश टॉट टू यू. तो दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एक्टिव एंड पैसिव वॉइस. स्टूडेंट्स आई होप आपको ये समझ में आया होगा. ओके आप ऐसे यू विल आल्सो राइट सम एग्जांपल्स अकॉर्डिंग टू योर ओन ओपिनियन टू क्लियर दिस कॉन्सेप्ट एज एक्सरसाइज. ओके गुड बाय.